it's you! Just the person I need. Oh, what I wouldn't give to have a space of my own. Sharing a dormitory all year has been simply miserable.
Samantha, is everything all right?
No, it's not. It's my brother William, the one I told you about after charms class. He's been cursed. He ignored my warning, and now he's lying in St. Mungo's looking completely pathetic. He simply never listens.
I'm sorry, how exactly has he been cursed?
Oh, you won't believe it. Truly, but his feet were turned into purple beets. You can imagine his distress. And mine. I won't even go into the attention he was getting from our garden rabbits before he admitted himself to hospital.
I'm so sorry. That sounds like a trying situation.
I'm glad you understand. Everyone else just laughs at me as if it's a joke. No compassion at all.
Well, it is an unusual situation. How did your brother end up like this?
It's entirely his own fault. I told him about some research I'd done recently on our ancestor Marmaduke Dale. In particular, my discovery that Marmaduke's tomb was cursed. My brother's always making fun of my discoveries. This time, he laughed in my face. Told me I'd misinterpreted my findings. As if that were possible. And to prove his point, he went right up to the entrance of the tomb and poof! His feet transfigured into beets.
How awful. I can see why you're upset. He definitely needs some help.
Exactly. He may be a cape flapper, but he's still my brother. And no one deserves such a fate to last forever, especially as the result of a single brainless mistake. Now I worry that if the curse isn't reversed, it could become permanent.
Can't the curse be broken?
Possibly. The curse stems from a crest that was stolen from Marmaduke. If the crest were returned to its rightful place upon his sarcophagus, then I believe that William's feet may be restored. You battled trolls when they attacked Hogsmeade, escaped a dragon, and I could tell by your work in charms that you're a skilled spellcaster. Returning a crest to a sarcophagus should be almost effortless for you. So, will you help us?
I can take the crest to Marmaduke's sarcophagus for you.
Oh, thank you! Thank you so much! You'll simply go into the tomb where Marmaduke was laid to rest and place the crest on top of his sarcophagus. According to my research, the tomb's been abandoned for centuries, so it should be a fairly simple task. You'll find it just east of the hamlet of Brockborough. Thank you for your help. My family is indebted to you.
I need to find the tomb near Brockborough and place Samantha's family crest on a sarcophagus there.
It's our troll slayer. Welcome.
Telling what lies in wait for me in there. Well, my feet didn't turn into beets. That's a good start.
Revelio.
Should have known a herbologist would use Devil's Snare.
Confringo!
Incendio! Rebellion.
Confringo.
Depulsor. Rebellion. Revelio.
Well, my feet didn't turn into beads. That's a good start.
Revelio. Revelio.
Confringo.
Glacius. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
A troll? You can't be serious.
Revelio.
Marmaduke certainly left behind more than plants. Sarcophagus. That should reverse the curse. Hopefully.
Revelio.
Samantha will be glad to hear that the crest has been returned. I certainly hope it reverses the curse.
Off on another adventure, are we?
I'm happy to tell you that I returned the crest to Marmaduke's sarcophagus just as you asked.
I thought as much. I received word from St. Mungo's that my brother's feet are back to normal. No more beats. Oh, I cannot thank you enough. It wasn't too much trouble, I hope.
Just a measly old troll. Nothing significant.
A troll? Oh dear, I'm so sorry. That's awful. No one has been in that tomb for centuries. But I can't say I'm surprised. Marmaduke seems to have been full of surprises.
Indeed he was.
Well, I suppose I should be going. I'm anxious to see my brother, who must be elated to have his feet back.
Of course. I certainly would be.
William and I are forever in your debt. Thank you again for what you did.
begin.
In my opinion,
today's lesson, we will cover a truly thrilling event. The Goblin Rebellion of 1752 and all its triumphant tragedy. But more specifically, we will address the devastating effects it had on the wizard milling industry. Actually, we do know the number. 632. But history occurs outside the classroom. And look, it's time for my constitutional. One can practically osmose the history flowing through Hogwarts.
I think the professor wants us to follow him.
And now for a stroll to the bell tower. Along with the rest of the castle, it was completed in the early mid-late. The hole in the bell towers that loom above it contain myriad interesting artifacts. Good to see you again. Recovered from that nasty bout of dragon pox, have we?
That wasn't me, Professor. I'm new here.
Are you? Welcome. No doubt you're eagerly anticipating my analysis of various wizarding councils, codes, statutes, and of course, goblin rebellion. Not all goblins are rebellious. Some venture into wizarding politics, such as Irgit the Ugly. Some are talented artisans, such as Bragbor the Boastful.
Did you say Bragbor? I think I know that name.
Well known for his metalwork. I would imagine much of his goblin wrought iron and silver has survived to this very day.
Oh, of course. Hodgok said he was an ancestor of Ranrok.
Where were we? Oh yes. Back to our class topic for today. Grimbold Weft, another notable historical figure. He's right nearby. Curious students can find him on display here in the bell tower entrance hall. And all students introduce themselves to this hero of Hogwarts. Grimbold Weft was responsible for...
Can you tell me where I might find Grimbold Weft?
Oh yes, Grimbold Weft. Quick with a needle and thread, that one. He's a fascinating artifact of the Goblin Rebellion of 1752. At any rate, he can be found nearby, perched in his case.
Revelio.
Sir Skaggledorf the Heedless once challenged a mountain troll to a game of chairs. Care to guess who won?
No, this isn't.
Revelio.
Oh yes, I So you found Grimbold Weft?
Yes, I rather enjoyed seeking him out.
The thrill of the scholarly pursuit. I know the feeling quite well. Now, let's turn our attention to the agreeability and general good nature of Sir Athbuddle. He's also nearby. See what you can learn from him for your next assignment. Standing in eternal but symbolic watch over the bell tower is a retinue of loyal knights, or rather, statues of knights, I should clarify. Keen-eyed students will spot the statue of Sir Athbuddle of the Cheerful Countenance nestled among the ranks. Training yards and sculleries.
Revelio.
Where his warm and approachable demeanor was celebrated by old friends and newcomers alike.
Professor Binns, I found the statue of Sir Athbuddle.
Ah, well done. Alas, Sir Athbuddle's affability was his undoing. Died instantly trying to befriend a basilisk. Eye contact is not always to be encouraged. So beloved was he that even some goblins mourned his passing. Of course, that did not bode well with the rest of the goblins, most of whom could not abide mourning the loss of a wizard.
Pity goblins and wizards can't get along.
True, but imagine how dull my lectures would be without goblin rebellions to discuss. History does tend to repeat. It is a series of patterns, a thought both comforting and disconcerting. The wise student, such as yourself, will learn from it. History is written by those who do their schoolwork, so they
Revelio.
Or at least, I like to say that.
Looks like we've all gone on another one of Binns' wild goose chases.
Lumos.
Oh!
Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora.
Uprooted the mighty oak.
Revelio.
Before you are the sapling.
Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Revelio. Revelio.
I'm uncomfortable.
Ha! You should be more careful!
Revelio. Revelio. Thank you. Revelio.
Wish I'd brought
Revelio.
I haven't been called Puffskeen Dunkin' once since you brought me that venomous tentacular leaf. I think I am actually braver.
Now that I have all my gobstones back, I'm ready to take on all challenges. If I can find any.
Revelio! Revelio.
Handy resource indeed.
Revelio.
Field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
I can sense someone close to you needs your help. Someone with the initial F.
Thank you.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Alohomora. Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Revelio. Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Revelio. This Dedalian Keys challenge is coming along nicely.
Then we could get rid of muggles like garlic. It's good Black's children are too young to attend Hogwarts.
Confringo! Revelio. 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 Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Trapped on the grand staircase.
Revelio.
Moved again. Still haven't lived that long.
Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Lumos. Revelio.
Never forget what that awful puff.
Revelio.
1421. What? Oh, that's class, that is.
Alohomora. Revelio.
Herself. It's a wonder she's not gobbled up by her own fanged geranium.
Revelio. Revelio. Accio. Revelio. 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 Alohomora. Revelio.
Mind now, damn you guys.
Revelio. Revelio.
You thought? If you thought more while we were alive, I wouldn't be trapped here with you. Now, excuse me.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Alohomora. Mine now, demiguys. Revelio. Revelio.
Who knows what would have happened to the school had it not been for you? We owe you our gratitude.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio. Lumos.
There's one person who can try to sort it.
Revelio.
There's only one common room that can get in. That's Hufflepuff. Been that way for a while. So Garlic says.
You're brave though, aren't you?
Revelio.
bet Black could tell a few tales.
Revelio.
Got it. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
My oldest is...
Revelio. Revelio.
I find if I try to look.
Revelio. Revelio.
Good thing Professor Weasley takes her role seriously, since Black clearly has no interest in his.
Oh, I remember that day.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Conjuring a pillow the other day.
Revelio.
Galleons and a historian's uniform.
I think even Serona's patience is tested by having Ferdinand's portrait back in the blue room.
Alohomora. Revelio. Lumos.
Jarvis.
I'm sure he's in at the present moment, dear master. We'll be sure to tell him how very much you respond.
If someone gets struck by a cursed broom, we do hope it's you.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio.